Hi, thanks for joining me. This is Marcus Devaney, Virtual Services Development Worker for YPS. Today we're just going to show you how to use iPhoto. Hopefully you've been using Pixar, and if you have had any problems with that then, or you want to be a bit more creative around it with iPhoto, then you maybe you're using your MacBook Pro to do that. So I'm just going to show you how to use iPhoto. So just go down here on this dock here, which is the got all the icons that you want, and this is iPhoto here. I'm just going to select that. What will come up here is a load of events, which really basically everything you've been doing, but we're going to look for a specific photo, which is in over on the left hand side. And then what we're going to do today is we want to look at cropping to make so it's a nice good image. And one of the images that I've got here is some flowers that I picked in my when I was doing a training video for how to crop and get good lighting. And I'm just going to select this image and then go to edit at the bottom here. Now this is a nice image relatively, but what we need to do is we just need to turn the image around. So go up to rotate. If that's upside down, there we go. So we can see what we're doing. And then we're going to go down to crop here. And then we're going to crop this quite tight, because actually what I want to see is I want to get to these flowers, because that's really what I want to have focus on. So we want also with the collage, we want to make sure it's square. So we're not bleeding the image when we put it in. So that's kind of okay. And then we just get done. And then we've got the image there. Now I may have gone and cropped a little bit too tight because the image is slightly blurred, but that's okay for now. And then we just go to effects, just put a nice effect on it. In Pixlr, you can put an antique effect onto it, which makes it look, you know, really, really kind of old, which is quite nice, I think. You can increase this effect by going up the measurements, and it just makes it more older looking. Or we can go to boost, which is just boost the colors, which is, we've seen that in Pixlr as well. And this just makes it quite vibrant. But then also to give it a nice sort of wispy look, we can put an edge blur on it, which like focuses on the flowers and just makes it more dreamy and more interesting. But then we can also go up to the warmer, just make the colors warmer, which I think that's a nice, strong, really good color image. And then we can just do the contrast as well here. And then what we're left with is quite a strong, vibrant cropped image, which is quite nice. So once we're finished, we want to add it to your album, which is just so that we know where it is in the future. And we'll put it in our iPhoto album here. There it is, and that's an image I've done before. So I want to. What we need to do now is export this. Now iPhoto's funny. It's not like when you do all the changes, it's saved on your computer. That's not how iPhoto works. It all does it internally. I think it does it. A Mac does it to keep the memory from your computer building up. But what we need to do is we need to export that if we're going to put that onto your collage or going to put that onto Facebook or wherever we want to do. So we need to go up here to File, and then go to Export. We want our image quite high. We want maximum. If you were doing it for YouTube, medium's okay. You don't need to go very high. And then that's it, really. You can name it if you want here. And then you just need to. No, that's not going to work. Yeah, so here. Let's go. and then that just names it for what it is. And then hit export, and then it'll ask you where you want it to go. For this, I'm just going to save it on the desktop, and then we can change it later. There you go. So if we minimize that, we can just see it's popped up over here. Can you see what I mean? It's not, even though it's in iPhoto, it's not out of iPhoto until you export it, so you cannot use it. So if you ever get confused that you've done things in the iPhoto and you just can't see it or can't find it on your computer, it's because you need to export it. So we'll just close that for now, and then that's your image there. So if we click on it, it'll just go into the preview. This is not in iPhoto, this is outside, and you can see it. And then we can use that to upload to Facebook or the website or whatever. Okay, thank you for that.